every nation right now is racing to make contact with Mars, if not in person, then at least with a robotic spacecraft, in preparations for humans to one day land on the red planet. And I hope you're all as excited as we are for a new nation joining the quest towards exploring Mars. We're talking about the United Arab Emirates. Yes, the United Arab Emirates is going to be the first Arab and Gulf region country to send a scientific mission to the red planet on July 20th. How exciting! The motivation for the mission started back in the year 2014, and for 6 years, the United Arab Emirates Space Agency and its collaborators around the world went into planning the mission and designing its probe. And now the UAE's dream is finally going to become a reality. The official name of the mission is Emirates Mars Mission, and the probe was given the name Hope Probe to represent the hope of the Emirati youth and nation to conquer space exploration, starting with a mission towards Mars. Fun fact, the word hope in Arabic is Amal. To pronounce it correctly, think of George Clooney's wife, Amal Clooney. It's literally the same name. The $200 million mission will be worth every cent, not only for the massive scientific advancements, but also for being the first in the Arab region and the Middle East to push its limits and visit the red planet. The Emirates Mars mission will not be landing on Mars. It is designed as a probe to orbit the planet and gather information remotely. The probe is very lightweight with only 1.35 kilograms, 2.97 pounds, including fuel, and dimensions up to 3 meters by 7.9 meters, 9.8 feet by 25.9 feet, and that's while the solar panels are open. The probe is equipped with 600 watt solar panels to collect enough power for the equipment on board and a 1.85 meter, 72 inch antenna to communicate back and forth with Earth. But what exactly will the probe be doing up there orbiting Mars? The mission goals are aligned with the international goals of the Mars Exploration Program Advisory Group, an international group that decides the most important scientific questions to be answered regarding Mars. The group proposes 4 major scientific goals. The Emirates Mars mission is especially concerned with the second of these goals, which is to understand the processes and history of climate on Mars, and more specifically, to study the lower and upper atmosphere of the planet. These goals are further broken down into 3 scientific objectives. 1. Analyzing the lower Martian atmosphere to understand the climate dynamics. 2. Analyzing the upper Martian atmosphere to understand the weather changes and the escape of hydrogen and oxygen. And 3. Identifying why Mars is losing hydrogen and oxygen into space. In satisfying these objectives, the Hope probe will eat Mars's first ever weather satellite, continuously monitoring Mars's weather during all the seasons from an orbital inclination of 25 degrees and a minimum orbital distance of 20,000 kilometers, 12,400 miles, to a maximum of 43,000 kilometers, 26,700 miles. The Emirates Mars mission objectives will be realized by 3 instruments aboard the Hope probe. The first is the Emirates Mars Infrared Spectrometer, or EMIR for short. This instrument will study the atmosphere of the red planet in the infrared spectrum of light and has a spatial resolution of 100 to 300 kilometers. The spectrometer will scan Mars's lower atmosphere to understand the distribution of water vapor and ice water, as well as dust, and it will also observe the thermal conditions of Mars's atmosphere. The second is the Emirates Exploration Imager, or EXI for short, which is a camera that takes 12 megapixel high-resolution colored images of Mars and observes the Martian atmosphere in both the visible and the ultraviolet spectrums of light. The visible light system has a surface resolution of 4.6 kilometers per pixel when the probe is at the farthest point to the planet and a resolution of 2.2 kilometers per pixel at the nearest point. The ultraviolet light system, on the other hand, has a surface resolution of 4.9 kilometers per pixel at the farthest point and a resolution of 2.3 kilometers per pixel at the nearest point. The imager was developed by both the Laboratory for Atmospheric and Space Physics at the University of Boulder, Colorado, in America, and the Mohammed bin Rashid Space Center in the United Arab Emirates, and it can capture up to 180 frames per second. The third is the Emirates Mars Ultraviolet Spectrometer, or EMUS for short. And this spectrometer will make observations only in the far ultraviolet spectrum of light. The spectrometer will be able to observe the ultraviolet emissions of hydrogen and oxygen and carbon monoxide in Mars's thermosphere and exosphere, as well as measuring the weather changes in the thermosphere. This instrument is also the result of collaboration between the Laboratory for Atmospheric and Space Physics and the Mohammed bin Rashid Space Center. The control and operation of the HOPE probe will be a collaborative effort between facilities across the world, not only in the United Arab Emirates. Let's start with the launch itself that will entirely be under the control of the Japanese Space Agency, JAXA. The probe will launch aboard the Mitsubishi Heavy Industries rocket H2A202 from the Tanegashima Space Center in Japan, and all functions related to the launch vehicle will also be performed and monitored by Mitsubishi Heavy Industries. The H2A202 is an excellent rocket to launch the HOPE probe. It's a two-stage engine rocket and is 53 meters, 174 feet tall, with a mass of 289 kilograms, or 637 pounds. Looking at the ground support teams, we will also find an international collaboration, starting with the Ground Station Communication Network that is assigned to NASA's Deep Space Network in Pasadena, California. And moving to mission design, that's going to be managed by the American company Advanced Space in Boulder, Colorado, where they will maintain the trajectory and maneuvers of the HOPE probe along the journey. Both the Mission Operations Center and the Science Data Center are located at the Mohammed bin Rashid Space Center in Dubai, where the Mission Operations Center is responsible for monitoring the spacecraft and the initial data processing. And the Science Data Center is responsible for all the storing and analysis of the data coming from the HOPE probe, as well as guiding future access to this data for the benefit of the international scientific community. The mission was scheduled to launch on Wednesday, July 15th, but the official Twitter account of the UAE Space Agency tweeted in the early morning of July 14th that the launch date had been pushed back to July 16th at 8:43 GMT. But on the 16th, the launch date was delayed for a second time to be between the 20th and the 22nd of July. The decision came due to bad weather conditions at the launch site in Japan. But don't be alarmed, delays happen all the time, especially due to the weather, because scientists can't quite predict it 100%. The launch window will extend until August 12th, so any other future unfortunate weather conditions that will result in delays within this window are manageable. But any delays later than August 12th will unfortunately be catastrophic, because this precise launch window is important to provide the perfect launch conditions between Earth and Mars. Once the launch is done and the HOPE probe is in space, it will deploy its solar panels to start powering the onboard systems, and the probe will start to maneuver itself into a trajectory towards Mars to reach the red planet 7 months later. Upon approaching Mars in 2021, the HOPE probe will start slowing down from a speed of 121,000 kilometers per hour, 75,000 miles per hour, to a speed of 18,000 kilometers per hour, or 11,000 miles per hour. And that's to allow for Mars's gravity to capture the probe into orbit. About half the amount of fuel is spent on the process of slowing down the probe. And it's a crucial process, because otherwise, the probe would continue on flying into space and miss the red planet altogether, and in that case it will be reduced to being a fancy piece of space junk. The process is also autonomous, with no interference from the ground teams whatsoever, because communication between Earth and Mars is delayed by a minimum of 13 minutes and a maximum of 26 minutes, so real-time maneuvers would be impossible. When Mars captures the HOPE probe successfully and it goes into capture orbit, the first 6 weeks will be spent on testing the onboard scientific instruments before doing any observations. The capture orbit is an elliptical 40-hour orbit at which the probe will approach Mars at a minimum of 1,000 kilometers, 620 miles, and a maximum of 49,380 kilometers, or 30,683 miles. The next step is for the HOPE probe to transition itself into another higher orbit around the red planet. From this new orbit, the probe will come as close to Mars as 20,000 kilometers, or 12,400 miles, and as far as 43,000 kilometers, 26,700 miles, and it will take around 55 hours for the probe to complete a single trip around the planet. This new orbit is unique because it will allow the probe to scan the whole of Mars and take planet-wide pictures and observations. So now the probe is on its targeted orbit doing some fancy science. But how are we going to get a hold of this data here on Earth? Data communication between the home probe and Earth will not be continuous, but rather for 6 to 8 hour intervals, and only twice a week. And during these intervals, the probe is expected to transmit more than 1 terabyte of data back to Earth. Once the data reaches Earth, it is ready to be analyzed and stored by the ground team at the Mohammed bin Rashid Space Center. The mission is set for a lifetime of one Martian year, that is 2 Earth years of scientific operations, starting in May of 2021, with the chance to be extended in the future to 2 more Earth years until 2025. With the Emirates Mars mission, the UAE aims for more than just the science. The nation looks forward to establishing its position and leadership in space explorations among the Arab region and the world. Furthermore, the UAE seeks to provide and build its own Emirati space facilities to help the nation further achieve its goals in the space sector, and in doing so, advances jobs in STEM fields among its people. The UAE will also aim big in the future, with Mohammed bin Rashid Space Center planning the Mars 2117 program. The program should pave the way to the United Arab Emirates to build its own Mars Science City here on Earth. The city will be a virtual human establishment in the heart of the United Arab Emirates. It will simulate the life conditions on Mars and its environment to prepare humans for when life on Mars is not just a dream, but a live reality. As we end this video, let us hope that the first United Arab Emirates mission to Mars is going to be a success from start to end, and may it pave the way to more upcoming Arab ventures to the Red Planet and space.